Translation will be done by me, Katie and OS 10,000.
Der letzte Tag, ganz früh am Morgen und es sind ganz viele Leute da, das ist toll. Ich freue mich sehr, dass Anita Hopes hier ist vom Mietshäuser-Syndikat. Sie hat 2010 ein...
So, welcome everyone who is up this early. We have Anita Hopes with us from Marburg, who is involved with the Mietshäuser-Syndikat, the Rental Housing Syndicate. Yeah, welcome to the stage. Hello and good morning. As I've heard, this is a talk which is actually before the breakfast, so I'm very happy that all of you already showed up. This is an analog form of hacking I will be talking about. The Rental Housing Syndicate is using organizational structures which usually support ownership, and we use them in a different way, so it gets to a different result. It's a way of organizing oneself in a self-organized manner. So we are using structures which are already there to get a different result. This is, sounds good, but it's kind of hard work because all this organizational stuff is slow and boring work.
Ist ja allgemein bekannt, dass der Wohnungsmarkt kapitalistisch organisiert ist.
It's well known that the real estate is very capitalistic. And this leads to high rental prices and high prices when you buy apartments. And it also leads to people renting an apartment to get thrown out of the apartment.
Wenn dir das jetzt nicht passt.
So if you're not happy about this, but you don't want to buy private property or are not able to buy your own private property, we are saying build networks and start doing something. So what we are doing is we buy property and we deprivatize it. We organize ourselves and we network in a solidarity way. So this is kind of weird because there's a very strong connection between buying something and owning it afterwards. But the way we are doing it is different. So when someone is starting a house project, in many cases they are in a situation in their life where they don't want to stay in one place for 40 or 50 years, or at least they don't really know yet at this point. And with buying this as rental houses, it's an alternative to just buying your own property. So it's, if you buy something with our concept, it's still a rental property. So you're still renting an apartment. You don't need to own it. You don't need to own your own private property. And this is why I think our concept is working that well. So the houses which are hacked in this way are unable to be resold. So if you look at how this is working, when you buy a house, it's very often a house which needs to be renovated, and you need to put in a lot of your own effort to keep this house up in a good state. So if you're not in a this kind of network, so in a later generation, when you come to a point where later generations now have this house, they might want to get rid of it again because they weren't involved in the founding process. And like with our concept, there is a guarantee for the people starting this house project that it will not be available in the real estate market again. It won't be resold later on. It will stay in this network, in this concept. So this is, I think, also very important in our hacking of the real estate market. If you have any kind of superior experience with self-organized groups, it's a shit ton of work to found your own organization, to go through the legal steps, to self-organize with the others who are interested to get involved. It's a lot of voluntary work. It needs very much engagement and very much time. So our answer is live more in more beautiful places with less capitalism. We decided for the rental apartment syndicate, which is an organization which was founded in 1992. And in the 80s, there were already the first steps towards this, which is kind of parallel to the CCC, because it was around the same time when both groups started to develop and grow. Currently, we have 155 house projects in our network, and the format of I'm talking about is a combination of Verein, so a German legal form, and kind of corporations, which is other legal form we have. So now we are looking at the map where the house projects are, and it's kind of random. And you see the development, how they are showing up. And right now you see them plopping up quite fast. But in real time, this is actually a very slow process. And when you look at the real estate development, a lot of stuff is gentrification is going really fast. But our way of doing it is compared to that is more of a turtle kind of way, so it's very slow. And this is kind of unpractical because other real estate systems in the market are a lot faster and sometimes buy out a house before we are able to. But because we are self-organized, the decisions to buy houses are sometimes too slow compared to other competitors. This is an issue I want to point out quite clearly.
At the end, we will have some time for questions on this. And then we can see whether there will be more questions than in the other talks that I've given.
Von vorne betrachtet geht's also los.
Looking at it frontally,
entweder weil sie ein Haus sucht,
a team of people are looking for a property because they might want to be living together, or more frequently, people are living in the same building and the statement comes that the building will be sold off. But you can make an offer yourself. And that overwhelms people. You have to align with the other people in the house. It's a slow process. But if they come to an agreement, then the idea would be that they found a club, a house club, and then they found a company. They need to organize money. You don't need to have the money yourself.
Wenn man Geld gut organisieren kann. Das heißt, man kann
there are people who can organize money well, people who can talk about it and talk about how it will be used.
Enorme Möglichkeiten gibt von
then there are enormous
Geld für Projekte zu bekommen.
Opportunities to get money for very good money.
Und in einem ganz bestimmten Format, auf das komme ich nachher noch
and it'll be given in a certain format.
Das kann dazu führen, dass die einfach die, der Anteil des Geldes, den man dann noch von Banken dazu leihen muss.
This will lead to a situation where the money that we need to lend, borrow from banks is very small.
Wenn alles klappt, kauft dann die Hausbesitzer.
So if everything works out, then this founded company buys the house. So it's not a syndicate yet.
Und viele Hausprojekte gehen auch einen solchen oder einen ähnlichen Weg.
And many of the projects go this way. There are other organizational forms. One would be a cooperative.
Auch kreative Möglichkeiten gibt.
There are many creative and varied possibilities to organize this.
Jeweils vor Ort auch schon ganz verschiedene Initiativen gibt.
There are different initiatives in place in different places. They are not centralized and they are not all networked. But if you go looking, you can find them, and it's very interesting to look at them.
Dann haben wir in der Mitte die Hausbesitz GmbH. Da ist auch so ein bisschen Haus.
If you do it like the syndicate, then in the middle is the company that has been founded.
Wenn wir links gucken, gibt's den Hausverein.
On the left-hand side, you see the housing club. That's the people who live there and they run the everyday business of that situation. Over various decades, they decide raises or lowering of rent. And on the right-hand side is a syndicate. And that is only important to prevent that the project could think of the idea to sell off the house. There are different parts and one part belongs to the club and one to the company and one to the syndicate.
Von der GmbH, also um diese mittlere Struktur zu kaufen, nur 12.400 Euro bezahlt. Viele Menschen denken,
so the syndicate, the syndicate has only bought a small part, and there are many housing projects, and they do everything by themselves, and there's a networking for know-how.
Dann gibt das Syndikat eben diesen etwas kleineren Anteil als
so in the money domain, they only give a small part, which is 12.400, and that entitles them to share.
Nochmal die Syndikats GmbH als Vernetzungs GmbH beschrieben.
So the limited company
Besitz GmbH ist also zu gleichen Teilen. Und das heißt also mit einem extra nochmal zusätzlich eingebauten Vetorecht. Das heißt, wenn eine Seite.
So the syndicate has a veto right on this.
Das habe ich schon gehabt. Das wiederhole ich gerne.
It's a shared ownership between the syndicate and the association actually living in the who's directly connected to the one property. So here I have a kind of graphic, which doesn't show all the project because 125 would be too many, and so we only have four here. So on the left side there are the associations, so that's the humans living in the buildings, and then we have the association which is partly owning the house, and then the other yellow thing is the syndicate, the limited liability company, who are co-owning it. And it only has one legal person running this, which is the syndicate. And this organizational structure is built up through, it can be single persons or it can be groups who are starting to form, who want to be involved, or it can be also other associations which are organized in the syndicate. So the aim of this networking is to spread the knowledge we have. So we have our, if you have a question, because you haven't run your own company before and haven't done all the financial stuff, then you can write to this mailing list we have. And it's not like in other mailing lists you might know, but you get a lot of responses who are sharing their experience, how they have been doing it with their own house project. Through this networking, the reprivatization of houses is impossible. So all the work that has been put into this project will be kept inside and will be kept for this project for all future generations. This, what I've been talking about, is very formal. All these legal stuff is just one part of it. But the other thing is with the people who are involved, because the people who are involved do learn a lot of stuff. And there are a lot of plenaries happening, which is important in our experience, because you are learning a lot through it. And it's about talking and making decisions together and getting to a consensus how you want to spend the money. And it's about running this association you have founded together to be the owners of the buildings. So in the beginning of a project, people who are starting to form a house project, who maybe have found a property, the people who want to start something, come to us, people who have been involved with the syndicate for a while, regionally, and then people from the syndicate come to this group, and it's often in very crowded apartments, and try to support them. We have a spreadsheet where we can calculate all the costs. So you have the price of the property and you put it into the spreadsheet, and this spreadsheet already has calculations in place for future renovations, which can have to be done, and so you can go into better, like when you're talking to the current owners, you can have better, you can be in a better place for negotiation, because you can already calculate what are the future costs, not only the costs of buying it in the first place, but also the cost of the renovations, so you can have better arguments to negotiate about the prices. So the rental prices in this area, we know quite a lot about them, and it's important that you have good estimates here, because all the private credits we are using to buy this, we want to pay the private people back and back out and so it's important to have good calculations to be able to do this. So we are doing both. We get loans from banks like normal, and also we get loans from private persons. So this is where you pay back the usual amounts, and like with the private loans, we have our own deals how much is paid back. So there is a general assembly within our syndicate, which has workshops, but also new house projects are introducing themselves. So where the regional people are talking with new house projects, and this is the first step, and this calculation we are doing, and then the next step is to for house projects to come to the General Assembly, which is an important step because there are a lot of people coming together from different regions with sometimes 30 years of experience, and they ask a lot of questions. So the new house project needs to consider these questions. And sometimes the new house project has to reconsolidate and like reconsider new questions, but in a lot of cases also it's going very well because with this large group where we are looking for a consensus all the time, sometimes it's very, very cool and it's an important step for the new project to get formally accepted into our syndicate. And to finding consensus is for us a very important thing, and it's also cool because you are learning a lot of new skills here, and it's a good way to organize oneself together. Also, we are looking at new things we can do for our organization, like buying properties in other countries. So let's summarize. You don't need your own money, but you need the ability to organize money to buy it. So you're still living for rent, but you have a lot of self-development options because you are self-organizing the house you're living in. So the do something in this case can also mean deprivatize your own hack space or your own living space, or put your money into this form of loaning and into a syndicate project. If you have questions but are not able to do this here, you can meet me at the Rocket outside. So also, to look forward, the syndicate, you have the website on this slide, it's syndicat.org. But there are a lot of other organizations also doing similar stuff. Like here in Leipzig, the website is down there. So here in Leipzig, there are 11 syndicate projects and a lot of projects who are organizing themselves differently.
Danke, Anita. Ihr kennt das Spiel. Stellt euch an die Mikrofone, wenn ihr eine Frage habt.
You know the game. Please go to the microphones. Here the signal angel has a question for us.
Es gibt eine Frage bezüglich der dieser Hausprojekte. Gibt es da Erfahrung?
So regarding the housing projects, do you have any experience how everyday problems are being dealt with? Somebody can't pay any longer or the flat deteriorates.
Konkret Sachen wie eine Zahlungsunfähigkeit.
So the question is about everyday problems, everyday issues, or if people run out of money. So it's actually the case that a lot of projects already have a lot of experience with living together before they start their project, but also this regional council organizations also can be contacted. So we are thing here is to support each other and communicate together. And so we also have workshops at our General Assembly about this. So usually the single projects try to organize the problems with money for themselves, and house projects are autonomous, and usually they find good solutions for issues like this.
Wir fangen mit Mikrofon 3 an.
Also vielen Dank erstmal.
Thank you very much for presenting this model on how to live together in this. I myself come from the domain. I would like to understand why you are choosing this structure with a syndicate above the individual associations. I could imagine that that the projects are organized as a smaller form of company, the GBR, and that the association is only in a consulting capacity.
So the question was about the structures and which tools to use to get to our main goals. So the case is for the GBR, which is a German form, all your private money is liable to this association. It doesn't matter how much money you have, it's all liable. And with a limited liability company, you only have limited liability. But so this is a process working for us very well, but there are a lot of other options who work for other people, and you can also find your new ideas for your own.
Thank you for the excellent talk. I would like to understand what scenarios could lead to insolvency of the housing limited association, limited company, and how does the syndicate's what is the syndicate's role in that situation? Are they liable? Is there any possibility that the house would fall back into the market?
So the last part of the question I got is if there is a possibility for any houses to get back into the free market. And so both owners, so the syndicate and the association owning the house, they both have to agree to sell this house again. This has only been the case once in the years since our existence, and we have learned a lot by this case, and we want to avoid this in the future. And for insolvency, we also have a case, and from previous experience, we have learned and have developed better tools. But in this one case, there were renovations being done, and we needed to pay more money for them. And there were still some people living there, already some people living there, but still a lot of flats were not inhabited yet. So the project ran bankrupt because they didn't get in enough money. So it's rare, but it's possible.
Hello. Do you have details on rental cost and cost to retain the building and how the financing is structured?
Frage 1.2 wäre dann, wie wird mit Prolongationsrisiken umgegangen?
And how do you deal with prolongation risk?
Looking at the only 1 minute, I don't think I have the time to go into detail, but the financial situation is 1/3 is money from banks, and the rest of the costs is from private loans. This includes also future renovation costs, not only the initial buying costs. So if you have a lot of bitcoins, just meet her at the rocket outside at the fairy dust. And there's a first round of applause.
I would like to know how the cash flow works. What happens when the house is paid off and all credit, all projects are done? What happens with the rental income?
There are different possibilities. The first step is that the private loans sometimes aren't paid back, but are replaced with other private loans. So the first project hasn't been in existence for so long that we have reached this step. And there are a new cost developed because of renovations and stuff. So for a long time, this step usually isn't reached. So it's an important basic principle we have that for one square meter which is rented out, it's 60 cents, roughly 60 cents, which are given away to the syndicate for us to be able to buy new properties. So this amount, which this part of the rent, which is going to the syndicate, the amount of money we raise through this is becoming bigger, so we are able to buy more houses.
Unfortunately, our time is over, but you can meet Anita at the Rocket and go into this topic more deeply. Thank you.
Thank you for listening to the translation of the power.